The last video was just the introductory video for the transportation engineering or the highway engineering or transportation system. Now we will see what is the characteristics of road transportation. The road transportation is economical and it is nearest to all different kinds of people. All classes of people can use this kind of transportation. The passengers and goods have to be first transported by roads before reaching the railway station or airport. Before reaching to any different kinds or any different mode of transportation system, before, in the initial stage, it has to be transported in the road mode itself. The places in the borders with high altitude or in the mountain or hilly areas with the difficult terrain system, the road system have been given for this kind of places also. For the village, the remote area, also there is a road network. The road network is very economical and convenient for even for the short trips and for long trips also. Now we will see the characteristics of road transportation one by one. The roads are used by various road vehicles like passenger cars, buses, cycles, etc. Almost all the kind of vehicles are transported on the road. It may be car, two-wheeler, buses, etc. But if I take the airways or waterways, there is only a single kind of mode over there. So, next one is the road transport infrastructure. The roadways require small investment compared to other mode of transportation. The infrastructure requirement, whatever the infrastructure they have to build in road transportation system, requires small investment compared to other mode of transportation. The road vehicle is much lower. The motor vehicles are much cheaper than other carriers like waterway, railway. The vehicles used in road transportation system, the two-wheeler, maybe car or buses, they cost more, that is more cheaper compared to the other mode of transportation, maybe the ship or the airlines. The road transportation system offer complete freedom to the road users to transfer vehicles from one lane to other accordingly to their need and convenience. There is more freedom. A person, if there is in this lane, he can turn up and come to different lane. But there are some rules and regulations, some traffic rules and regulations. But compared to other mode of transportation, the freedom to use this mode is more convenient and more efficient. The road is flexible for change in location, direction, speed, time of traveling, everything. It is a flexible mode of transportation. It is one of the flexible mode. And there is a door-to-door facility in only the road transportation system. It is possible to travel directly from respective place of origin to the destination. From any point of origin till destination, the road system will directly connect. Then, road transportation is good for shorter distance. Speed of movement is directionally related to severity of accident. If the speed taken or the speed of the movement is more, then it in turn results in the accident. So road safety is must and should, as the road safety decreases with increasing in running speed. Then road is the only means of transport that gives service to one and all. This mode of transportation gives service to one and all, the whole section of the society. JICA committee recommendation. Over the period after the First World War, the motor vehicles using the road increased. As such, the demand of better road network that carrying a mixed traffic condition is also increased. The demand for the better road network is also increased. As the existing road was not capable to withstand the mixed traffic, then the Indian government appointed Mr. JICA. The Indian government appointed Mr. JICA as a chairman for Road Development Committee. Indian government appointed this person as a chairman for Road Development Committee to study the situation and to recommend suitable measures for road implement. That is in 1927. Then the JICA committee, whatever the committee formed under the chairmanship of Mr. JICA, the JICA committee submitted the report in the year of 1928. The recommendations made by the JICA committee are: the road development in the country should be considered as national interest. That is, the road development in the country should be considered as wide national interest. Then, an extra tax should be put on petrol for road users, named as Central Road Fund. Central Road Fund. Extra tax should be put on the petrol. Next is, the semi-official technical body should be formed to develop the road of various parts of the country. To develop the road at various parts of the country, a semi-official technical body should be formed. A research organization should be started to carry out the research and development work to be available for consultation. These are the four recommendations made by JICA Committee of Research. These are the four recommendations made by JICA Committee. The recommendations of the JICA Committee was accepted by the government, and in that, the major recommendations were implemented. The three major recommendations that were implemented are the Central Road Fund, Indian Road Congress, and Central Road Research Institute. The Central Road Fund in the year 1929, Indian Road Congress, IRC, in 1934, Central Road Research Institute, CRRI, in the year 1950. These are the three major recommendations of JICA committee implemented by the government. Now we will see one by one about these three recommendations that were implemented. The first one, Central Road Fund, CRF. The Central Road Fund was formed in 1st March 1929. The consumers of petrol were charged on extra levy of 2.64 paisa per liter. From 20% of annual revenue, it has to be retained for meeting expenses on administration of road fund. Road experiment and researches was carried out on this 20% of annual revenue. Then the remaining 80%, of the fund are to be allotted by central government on various state based on actual petrol consumption or revenue allocation. The 20% is kept for meeting expenses or any experiment made on road or bridge projects. Other 80% of the fund is allotted by central government to various states based on the revenue collected on that places. The account of Central Road Fund was maintained by Accountant General of Central Revenues. The control of the expenditure is exercised by the road wings of Ministry of Transport. The control of the expenditure is exercised by the road wings of Ministry of Transport. That is with Central Road Fund. Next, we will go with the second one, Indian Roads Congress. The Indian Road Congress was the semi-official technical body suggested by JICA committee and formed in 1934. Indian Road Congress is a semi-official body suggested by the JICA committee formed in the year 1934. The IRC was constituted to provide a forum of regular technical pooling of experience and ideas of matter affecting the planning, construction and maintenance of road in India. This committee was supposed to give all the kind of ideas which affect in planning and construction and maintenance of the road. The IRC will prepare the standard specification that provide the platform for the expression of professional opinion on the matter relating to the road engineering, including organizational and administration. That is, they were given the standard specifications, IRC specification. And if there is to meet any changes, people over there were recommending the different things. Next one is, IRC played important role in formulation of all the road development plans in India. It was a important role in formulation of road development. Now, IRC has become an active body of national importance in controlling the specifications, standards and guidelines on materials, design and construction of roads and bridges. The IRC has a specified book, the IRC code. It is like a code book. They have made a specific guidelines for the design, material and construction. IRC publishes journals, research publications, as I said, specifications, guidelines in various aspects of highway engineering. IRC works with the collaboration of road wings of Ministry of Surface of Transportation, Government of India. They work in the collaboration of road wings of Ministry of Road Transportation. Next, the third one is Central Road Research Institute, that is CRRI. The Central Road Research Institute was recommended by JICA committee and it started in the year 1950 in New Delhi for carrying out the research pertaining to road technology. The Central Road Research Institute is one of the National Laboratory Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. It is one of the national laboratory. The institute is mainly engaged in carrying out the applied research in various aspects of highway engineering and offers technical advice to state government and industries on various concerning roads. The Central Road Research Institute is mainly engaged in carrying out all different kind of research in highway engineering and they give advice to state government and industries in various road concerning problems. Next, we will see highway development and planning. Highway development and planning. Highway design is only one element in overall highway development process. The design process is single element in overall highway development process. During the first three stages, that is planning, project development and design, the designers and the committee, these are the planning stages, that is planning, project development, final design, right of way and construction. This is the planning stage. In the first three stages of planning, project development and design, the designers of the committee working together can have greater impact on the final design. When the people work togetherly in these three stages, in the final design or the final output will be of more effective. This is the highway development and highway planning system. Next, we will see what is the objectives of highway planning. Objectives of highway planning. The planning is considered as prerequisite before attempting any development program. Any kind, maybe any kind of a planning. Before going for the actual thing, we plan what to do, how we should do, what are the things in that. In developing countries like India, it is important to utilize all the available funds in the best possible manner by restoring a best planning principle. To plan the overall road network for efficient and safe traffic operation, but to the minimum cost. The cost of construction and maintenance has to be made lower. To arrive at the road system, the length of different categories of road which could provide maximum utility and could be constructed within the available resources during the plan period under the construction. To divide overall plan into phases to decide the priorities. Overall, the complete plan will be divided into different phases. To fix up date-wise priorities and to plan for future requirements and improvements of road in view of anticipated developments. To work out the suitable financing system. This is the overall objective of highway planning. This is the overall objective of highway planning. Next, we must know what are the phases of highway planning. What are the phases in highway planning? There are two main phases in highway planning. One is assessment of road length requirement for an area. What is the road length required for the area? And next is preparation of master plan showing the phasing of plan in 5-year plan or annual plan. Initially we will assess, next we will prepare a master plan. This is the two main phases in highway planning. There are two terms we say differently, the road and highway. Sometimes we say road system, road connectivity. Next we will say highway system, highway network. When we say road, it refers to the route or the way between two places, typically being paved, otherwise improved to allow the travel. Maybe any kind of pathway. But when we say highway, highway is a public road, especially a major road connectivity between two or more destinations. Any interconnected set of highways are referred as highway system, highway transportation system. Classification of roads. First, we will see types of roads. Basically, there are two categories, that is all-weather road and is another one is fair weather road. All weather road, the roads are negotiable during all weather excepted at major river crossing. Permissible up to certain limit of extent, the road pavement should be negotiable during all weather. All weather road is nothing but in all the kind of weather the road could be used. Fair weather roads. On this roads, the traffic must be interrupted during monsoon season and causeway during streams and overflow across the roads. This is the two comparison between all weather road and fair weather road. This is a basic category. And based on the carriageway, the road system is divided into two types, that is paved road and unpaved road. As the name indicates, the road which have been paved with hard pavement surface on the carriageway is called as paved road. The road which don't have this hard pavement surface on the carriageway, or the earthen road or gravel road, is called as unpaved road. And based on the pavement provided, the roads are classified into surface roads and unsurface roads. As the name indicates, the road provided with a bituminous or cement concrete surfacing is called a surface road, and the road which are not provided with those kind of surfacing is called as unsurface roads. Roads are provided with bituminous surface are also called as black topped roads, and that of concrete are referred to as concrete roads. These are the basic classification or basic division. Next, we will go for methods of classification of roads. What are the methods based on which the roads are classified? The roads are generally classified based on, first one, traffic volume, second one, load transported, that is tonnage, and third one is location and function. Based on these categories, based on these three categories, the road is classified. See, first one, based on traffic volume, classification based on traffic volume or tonnage have been arbitrarily fixed by different agencies, classified as, see, that is classified based on the traffic volume, the road is classified as heavy, medium, light traffic roads. These are the three divisions that are classified under traffic volume. And the second one is road transported, that is load transported or tonnage. Based on load transported and tonnage, the roads are classified in two classes, that is class 1 or class A, or next one is class 2 or class B. This is based on load transported or tonnage. And the third one is location and function. Based on location and function, the Nagpur road plan classified the roads in India based on location and function. This is the road plan, Nagpur road plan. This classified the Indian road based on location and function. And that is into five categories. They are National Highway NH, State Highway SH, Major District Roads MDR, and Other District Roads ODR. Fifth one is Village Roads. These are the five categories classified under location and function. If I take first one, National Highway NH, this national highway connects between the capital cities of states and the capital cities of the port. The NH has at least two lanes. This NH has at least two lanes of traffic and 7.5 meter wide and has concrete or bituminous surfacing. Next, state highway. State highway are the main roads within the state, and these also have a width of 7.5. Next one is major district roads. The road connects the area of population and market with either the SH or railway, the state highway or the railway, the major district roads should have at least metal single lane carriageway of 3.8. This road carries a mixed kind of traffic. And next is other district roads. The roads connected the village to other village, one village to other village, or the nearest district roads with connectivity of ghat, rivers. This road have single lane with mixed traffic. Next is village road. These roads, like other district roads, connect village to village to nearby district roads. This village roads, it will connect this village to district road. This road carry mixed traffic. These are the classifications of roads. See, the road classification is made based on traffic volume, the load transported, and location and function. These are the three modes on which the road is classified. Modified road classification as per third 20-year road development plan in the year 1981 to 2001. This third 20-year road development plan has modified road classification. Whatever the road classification we saw before, that classification has been modified in this plan. That is, primary road system, secondary road system, and tertiary road system. These are the three kinds of system which was modified. The primary system consists of expressway and national highway. The secondary system consists of state highway, major district roads. The tertiary system consists of district roads and village roads. This was the modified classification. This was the modified classification. Next, we will see classification of urban roads. The road system within the urban areas are classified as urban roads. The road system which are there in urban areas are classified as urban roads, which will form a separate category of the rural roads or different road system are different. But the urban road system forms a separate category of roads taken care by respective urban authority. But this urban road was not included in the target of third 20-year road plan. Whereas this urban road were not included in that plan. The urban roads are classified as arterial roads, sub-arterial roads, collector street, local street. These are the four road system of urban category. Arterial, sub-arterial, collector, local streets. Arterial and sub-arterial roads are primarily for thorough traffic on continuous roads, and sub-arterial road has lower level of traffic mobility compared to the arterial roads. The collector street provide access to arterial roads, and they collect and distribute the traffic from local streets, which provide access to attributing property. That is, these collector streets provide the access to arterial road from local street. This is the classification of the road system.